Hello friends. This short video is a continuation of the story about the Zigbee Switch Aqara Z1 Canon, specifically about the newly added support in the Xiaomi Gateway 3 and the Mihome Smart Home Management System. If you haven't seen the first part of the video, I'll leave a link in the description. You should start with it. As usual, before we begin, I ask you to like the video, as it helps with the promotion on YouTube, and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss new reviews and lessons. Not so long ago, when I was testing the Zigbee Chandelier Aqara L1, you can find the review link in the description, during a firmware update of the Xiaomi Gateway 3, I noticed that the list of changes included support for the Aqara Z1 switches. I am using the mainland China region. Let's check if this is true. I go into the Gateway plugin and start the mode for connecting new devices. The Aqara Z1 Canon switch series is fully present here. The switch automatically goes into pairing mode after the power is connected. Remember that for this model, having a neutral wire is optional. The device works with or without it. To manually switch modes, press any of the buttons twice and within 5 seconds after that, hold down the button until the blue LED starts flashing. The connection went smoothly on the first try, without any problems. After that, the initial setup wizard starts, where you can specify the location of the device, name it, change the icon for each of the buttons, and immediately add it to one of the basic scenarios. Now, the icon of the switch is visible in the selected location and in the menu of the gateway to which it is connected. Let's see what's in its plugin and whether the same functionality is available as an Aqara Home. In the main window of the plugin, there's control for each of the channels, and in this version, there are two. There are additional buttons for simultaneously turning on and off all the relays. If you have connected the neutral line, the energy monitoring function will be available. There is also a log with a history of triggers. In the scheduling menu, there are two types of tasks, specific and periods. Specific tasks imply a one-time action at a set time. Here, you can turn on, turn off, and toggle the state of each of the relay channels, as well as control activity indicators. Each task can be either one-time or periodic, on set days. Periodic tasks differ in that they have two time settings, start and end. This reduces the number of entries created in the schedule. Otherwise, everything is the same as for specific tasks. In the top right corner, press the button with three dots to access the settings menu. In addition to standard options such as name, location, appearance of buttons, firmware version check, and removing the device from the gateway, there are several special options. In this menu, you can disable the key binding from controlling the relay. Essentially, this turns the switch into separate devices, logical buttons for use in automations, and a two-channel relay with energy monitoring. There's a setting for the state after power restoration, always off, always on, and remember the last status. I checked the key setting menu, but unfortunately, there are only options for the name, location, and icon, with no special functions. At the very bottom of the list, I found two more options that I checked. The first, when turned on, displays the switch not only on the page of the selected location but also on the first screen of the application. The second activates the display of each button of the switch separately. And these screenshots are from the Aqara Home app. It had many interesting features, such as synchronization of switch operation and determination of the type of load. More details on how they work, with a visual demonstration, can be seen in my first video. In Mihome, as of the test date, these features were not found. In automations, the switch can be used in the triggers section. Here the statuses of each of the relays are available, whether they are on or off, as well as button press events. There are only single clicks. Compared to Aqara Home, the relay statuses there are divided into events and conditions, turning on and off as separate triggers, and on, off as an addition to another trigger. Logical clicks, also only single ones. In the actions section, which will be activated in case of a trigger, here are turning on, turning off, and toggling the state of each of the switch relays, as well as state indicators. Compared to Aqara Home, here, in addition to the options already listed, there is the possibility to programmatically enable and disable the keys from controlling the relay. I will also test the possibility of working with this switch in Home Assistant in case of connection to the Xiaomi Gateway 3. The first option is the eponymous integration, which is installed from HSCS. In my case, the gateway provides control of several devices. However, the switch is not among them. Apart from the gateway itself, only Bluetooth devices were found, several types of temperature and humidity sensors with and without clocks, as well as a nightlight. The second option is the HomeKit protocol, which is supported by this gateway, albeit in a very limited form. Most of the devices I tested did not appear in HomeKit. The Switch was no exception, it's not there. So for working with Home Assistant, Xiaomi Gateway 3 is not the best option. Now, to the merits of the Switch, which, I remind you, include the ability to work with or without a neutral wire, extended operating modes, type of load, synchronization, and now we can add support in Mihome. True, it is only in basic form, relay control, energy monitoring, and key unbinding, but that's not insignificant. The main thing is that the support itself is almost fully implemented. That's all. I hope this video was useful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes, as it helps promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and lessons, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. In the description, I will leave links to stores where you can buy this device, other videos on this topic, as well as my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for smart home discussions. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to all.